It's really astounding that so many families in Washington today face so many barriers to being healthy. In a state of such wealth and opportunity, it's just unacceptable that we have 1 in 5 kids who doesn't know where their next meal is coming from, that we have nearly half of our kids entering kindergarten without being ready. And that percentage goes up for low-income kids. For children to thrive, they need access to nutritious food, health care, early learning resources, and all of their vaccines.
A kindergarten exemption rate of around 4.5% might not sound alarming, but we are triple the national average. When the rate gets that high, we put ourselves at risk for actual outbreaks of vaccine-preventable disease. Parent advocates are trusted leaders in the spaces where their children spend time who we recruit to promote immunization as a social norm in their communities.
I want my kids to be as healthy as they can. Part of that is getting their immunizations.
Within Reach supports our parent advocates numerous ways. That starts with a half-day training at the beginning of the school year where we teach them about vaccines, we meet with the health department, we talk about communication science, we role play, we idea generate, and the list goes on.
And they give us plenty of materials to look through, as well as offering materials in other languages, which to me was a big plus.
The concept of the immunity community implies that we're all in this together, that we are a collective, that we are focused on the public and the well-being of the public.
And we support parents and communities to speak up for vaccines. We know we're impacting long-term change. Sometimes the need is more urgent, however, and we need to respond quickly. One example is a recent event that we helped plan at Spruce Elementary with lots of community partners. When we were asked to help, we mobilized quickly to provide assistance.
And they were saying that they had about 30 students who were not immunized. And then I thought, wow, how do we get help?
The district was going to crack down and say those kids could not come back to school.
We hosted the event one evening, contacted parents who were identified as failing to meet all of the needed vaccinations for their children. The intent was to make sure that those kids were able to continue going to school. And so on site, we had nurses that were there to provide the vaccines, someone who had already identified what vaccines were necessary and could explain that to the parents.
Within Reach was instrumental in ensuring that during the event, there were multicultural, bilingual, in-person assisters provided not only the work at the school, but they also ensure that the families that were being enrolled at the school were able to follow up.
All it took was a few people speaking up, and all the different partners saw something more that they could add to it.
So the children were able to come back to class when the school resumed.
I love that I can talk to a family, help them connect with a peer support group, and find out that they have some questions about insurance. I can just pop on over to my colleague and say, hey, can you help them figure this out? And so on the spot, they're able to get that need met.
Our role is to make it easy, and I think that we do a really good job of that. Just from interacting with people, you hear that sense of relief when they call in concerned about their health insurance or about their nutrition benefits and their child's development.
The more I connect with families and help families connect with resources, I see that we're all connected. And if a family in a community isn't thriving, it radiates it. It affects everybody.
It's a basic right. It's a basic human right to have access to food and to health care. Everyone should have that. If you exist in a community where that's not a norm, we should all be doing something actively to change that. The health of my neighbor impacts me as well.